Miller Park in Reseda for a year, shooting heroin and coke every day.
Hype and people are getting together saying, you know, okay, we'll look like this and we're gonna play like this and then we're gonna get signed. People just get together in the garages and jam with friends.
The real jam and bands in Seattle are real bands.
It's been like that for quite
some
time.
Not three hairdos.
Like Lane said, it's something that's been going on for a while. I think it's
just now caught on, and then now it's pretty much record labels pretty much ate up everybody, and then they'll move on to another town, you know, like,
yeah.
Probably Goober, Idaho is the next big rock band.
There's a show every night in LA, but in Seattle there's like one every month, two a month, something like that, so the fans get more pumped up. And they're just more supportive to their local bands.
And if they like you,
if they like you, they really like you. In LA, it's like they like you, but they don't want to admit it.
yeah, they're okay.
Wait, one thing.
We rock for Jesus.
And we're huge in Guam. Guamies love us.
So, there's one thing I'd like all the other bands to know. We are the worst smelling band.
Yeah, we smell
worse
than you.
Hey, this is Lane.
Sean!
From Alice in Chains.
Metal.
Hanging out here in beautiful Guam. It's pretty nice here. The weather's nice.
Nice.
We just shot our second video for CSR. We're gonna try and meld the two together.
Gel. Meld.
You know, it's got a gel. And first one sucked. This one might suck too. Who knows? I don't care anymore.
I don't even like the fucking song.
Fuck it.
Our hairdos weren't good enough for the first one.
The videos.
So when we got here to LA, we got a weave. We all got weaves. And and I got the new tits. Rest of them. Look at those. Zoom in. Huge. It's still sore.
And real firm.
We like to tour. We like to not bathe and change our clothes. We're good at it. What do you think?
I've been wearing the same pair of underwear since 87. Damn proud of it. You opened fire, and your luck was true. You opened fire, and my smile is cold.
We played a lot of the places that we play with Van Halen on this first leg with The Clash, so it'd be kind of cool coming back around. Van Halen could go for quite a while, and so we're just going by ear. Probably before this, we'll probably have to go back. We'll go back, I'm sure, on this album again. That's what we've kind of been hearing, and we haven't been to Japan. We'll probably go to Japan, Australia.
So Van Halen could go on a while. What does that mean? Like you're solidified for a certain number of dates, but after that, it's up in the air.
Each leg, they'll tell us if they want to keep us on, and it could go up to 9 months.
Wow.
I think 6 months.
What?
How did you get all these offers? I mean, it seems like you must be just a big favorite among all these
fans. My fucking knees.
Spend a lot of time on our knees.
a lot of times there's buy-ons, you know, where you gotta pay to go on a tour. What the fuck is that? You gotta go pay, spend your own money to go on tour, I don't know.
To get seen by, you know, a lot of people, you buy onto a big tour.
Yeah, it's just fucking weak.
We haven't had to do that yet.
We got one album and been touring on it for a year, and we got all these other songs that we can't really play because nobody knows them. And playing that one album for another year would probably, I mean, you'd have to hit me with a ball peen hammer in the back of the head and take me out of my misery. Why with anybody. We're not into, as long as we get to play our music, you know.
We won't play with Trickster or Nelson, and we won't play with Slaughter.
Slafter?
Dana Strum, he's not a goofball. And we won't play with King of the Hill, because that guy has a faggy mustache and blue eye contacts. You are a total fag. Sorry. There's a lot of confusion on the road. I mean, it's pretty hellish lifestyle. It gives you a lot to think about, a lot to write about, a lot of ideas. I think releasing the dark side, releasing depression, frustration is what we're all about. That's what we're trying to do through our music, and I think it, you know, it affects people in a positive way. It can give them something to relate to, and they can release the same demons. Ooh, spooky.
We only eat dark meat too, so I mean, it's all, everything we do dark. Notice the garb. I mean, I'm a dreary guy. I'm a down guy. I'm a downer. Where the down guys go? No. Blatantly, we're Satanists. So I mean, long live Satan, Satan, Satan. Satan, hey. As you wallow in a sea of sorrow, I live tomorrow. So we've had like probably, you know, two and a half months off since the album came out. But I mean, you go home for more than 2 weeks, you just go fucking crazy. You're just sitting there and you're so used to every day you have something to do.
Get
up and you gotta go, and it's like gives you a feeling of worth, and then you go home and you just sit around and...
Gives me a feeling of girth. I always feel really fat when I'm touring. So.
You go home and you just sit around and it's great for a week or two, and then it just gets really boring and start drinking more and